When I was six, little did I know a fishing trip with my dad would change the shape of my life forever and start an obsession spanning longer than 25 years and still burning stronger than ever today. Carp fishing to me is a personal journey, and I've always set myself new targets to become a better angler. I've always wanted to do things the right way, meaning in order, and I soon went on to catch my first 20, 30, and 40 pound carp.
40 pound 8 ounces, but just look up. Look at the scales on that.
This fantastic hobby has taken me across Europe.
Ready? Yeah! 47 pound up! Come on!
Bit of auto damage on the tower or something.
And I've also made some of my most fondest memories and friends on the bank.
Well, last one. Here
comes
the
ferries
over there. There you are. Oh! Same off! Same off! Over the last couple of years, even though I've caught some amazing carp, something has been missing from my fishing. So now I'm back to take on the ultimate challenge any UK carp angler can think of. I am Sean Shoesmith, and this is my quest for a 50.
Come on, get in!
Hello, hi, and welcome. Finally, you join me back on the bank for another episode of Just One Run. This time, it's Quest for a 50. Now, we've had the lockdown. I just want to start off by saying I hope everyone made it through the lockdown unscathed. No one in their family. I hope everyone's family's okay. And it looks like we're slowly and surely beating this thing. We're back on the bank, and so much has happened since we've been back. So much to bring you up to date with. You actually join me in session on my new syndicate on my 9th night. We've got 9 nights to bring you up to date with. I got here yesterday, nothing's happened, so it felt like the right time while being quiet to bring you up to date on everything that's gone on and up to speed. So let's not hang about, let's dive straight in. Here's what happened in the first week's one and week two. Enjoy.
When we finally got the news every angler in the country was waiting for, that we was allowed to fish again, it was like a weight had been lifted off my shoulders. If you, like me, use fishing as a coping mechanism for mental health, this news was long overdue. With all the excitement and anticipation, all the members of my new syndicate took to social media to discuss rules and regulations on our return to make things fair for everybody. So to keep things fair, we all decided we'd only be allowed to fish for 24 hours to start off with. Also, we agreed to meet at a car park on the day in question at a certain time and make a draw for the swims so everyone got a fair crack of the whip. But unbeknown to me, when I turned up, some of the existing regulars were already set up in some of the favourite swims on the lake. However, with that taken on board, I did manage to set up in a swim that controlled a corner of the lake on the back of the wind. I quickly set about getting three rods out with some higher track singles and a healthy scouring of boilies around each rod, and decided to stand back that day and take everything in. But other than the dubious behaviour by the anglers and an unwanted pike chasing my deeper, nothing much else happened that week. But with all the knowledge I had gained from that short session, it was enough not to make the same mistake twice, and in week two, I was out the door at 3 a.m. This decision here will become pivotal to my success on the oncoming weeks. But this time I managed to beat everybody and was first on the gate. I managed to set up in a very popular swim called the Slips, where I'd seen fish earlier that day walking around the lake. And this time I was armed with some bait. A mix of the link boilie, boilie crumb and pellet. And a very similar mix was added to some solid bags. And fish already in the swim and not wanting to spook them, I quickly deployed three rods to the far margin using a bait boat. With the morning drifting past and the conditions even more turning in my favour, even more fish entered the swim. And I knew it wasn't going to be too long before I was holding my first Essex Syndicate carp.
30 pound 8 ounces. A brilliant fear of carp. And this is one of the babies in here. So let's get her back, show you exactly what I've done to catch this fish, and we see if we can catch one of the mothers.
After releasing that fish, I knew this was turning into a golden opportunity, so I quickly set about getting the rod on the exact same spot. And 10 minutes later, it was off again. Three, two, one, go!
There we go, what a wicked start to this campaign. Never I thought I'd get off to this. I thought I'd have to get my eye in first, but there again, same spot in the margin, a solid bag. We'll go through our abundant and tide that tomorrow, but for now I'm going to get this one back because there's fish in the area, and there's a lot more bigger than this one. We're not going to weigh him, he's only about £20, but we're putting back in. I'm looking forward to the night.
But before I could even think about what the night would bring, the middle rod ripped into action. And not long after, it was fish number three.
That's what happens, guys, when it is royally kicking off. I've just put that comment back. And the middle rod on the margin out there on a solid bag again, just slightly further up the margin, just out there in the middle of the screen there. The other fish come from down there. Yeah, unbelievable. I've got my new camera with me, but I haven't got all the bits to it yet, so I'm not starting to film. So this is all still on my phone. I am trying to make the vlogs better, and you will see that as we go on. The vlogs will be much better, much better video quality, microphone quality. I'm just in process getting all the bits now. So I've not done much filming today, as I've been mesmerised by the lake and what's been showing out there. I've had fish on me, and I'm sure this is not going to be the last one tonight. So, yeah, bear with me, and we'll get the video over.
Guys, I'm going to be quick with this one because we're just losing the light and I want to get the rod back out because, as you can tell, it's absolutely pandemonium. I never even thought this would have been like this on my first session here. Three fish, I've hardly done no camera work, so I do apologise if it don't look that great. I'm in due course of getting all the other camera bits, microphones, everything. I've actually ordered it, just waiting for it to arrive. All my night lights for videography so I can get the actual runs on camera. I could have actually done that today, but it's just been so mad. But got another stocky here. It's probably about 22 pounds, I would say. I've not weighed it yet. Oh, definitely, yeah. 22, 23 pounds, easy. Yeah. An angry little stocky there. Angry little male. Definitely. But yeah, I'm going to get him back. Not going to mess around too much with him. I'm going to get him back because when you've got 50s and like 20, 40s swimming about, you need to be getting them rods back on the spot as soon as possible. I've got one out, I just wanted to deal with a fish and get the other one out, but look at that, brilliant. We'll see what the night brings, eh? Because somehow I don't think this is going to be the last one, because they're just in the swim on this warm southwesterly, and I'm right on the end of it. Brilliant, come on.
Yeah, well, it was after them three fish that things went a bit pear-shaped. If it wasn't for my bloody mate Tiny ringing me up every day talking about bloody fishing, I wouldn't have got myself into this situation. I was having my phone, I see a pike in the margin, and I tried, there was loads of tadpoles pecking at this pike, so I tried to I was on the phone at the time to my mate Tiny, and at that point I tried to FaceTime him to show him the pike, and he couldn't quite see it through FaceTime. Me forgetting I had my phone fixed on my phone a few months ago, and once you do that, your phone's no longer waterproof. So I've dipped my phone under the water on FaceTime to show Tiny the pike, and got my phone back out, and lo and behold, there's no Tiny more anymore on the phone. There's nothing. My phone's broke, so I haven't got a phone. I hadn't got all the pieces to my camera yet. That first piece you just saw, some of that was still filmed on my phone, and some of it was the camera, but mainly my phone, because I was still gathering the pieces to my camera, my new camera, to get all of these blogs better and more up to date. And yeah, I only had my phone this week with me, and once my phone had gone, I had no phone for the rest of the night. I didn't know the time. I was going the next morning, so if I had a decent fish, I would have been knackered for camera work and stuff like that. And as it happened, I did catch another carp. I think it was about £26, if I remember correctly. So I didn't worry about waking another angler up for a £26. I just slipped it back, but that put me on four fish, and only in week two. Unreal, really. And yeah, as you can see, I was getting up early, and nothing was going to change going into the third week. And after the success, I was really, really confident to get back. Here's what happened.
True to form, I left my house even earlier. I was getting used to being the first one there. And after a quick lap round the lake, I checked my phone to check on the conditions that we was expecting. And sure would have it, they were due to be the exact same as the week before. With the conditions in mind, I decided to set up in the same swim as last week and quickly run round there and threw my gear down. And you know what they say, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So the same tactics were deployed again, but this time before the fish moved in. and with the day turning to night very quickly and the conditions due to turn in my favour, had I made the right decision? Only time would tell. I do remember one thing though, even if I didn't catch, I would never get bored of these Essex sunsets. The decisions and the tactics have paid off, and I was greeted with not one, but two fish that morning.
Just a minute, let me get in the middle of the screen. It's been absolute manic this morning, sorry if I'm speaking a bit low. But I'm not sure if I had this fish the other day actually. It's £23. But we've got one even bigger in the net. It's absolutely gone bonkers this morning. It's only 4:30. That's why I'm speaking a bit lowly. But we've got off to a great campaign. Got off to a great start, sorry. And yeah, we keep catching them, so that's all we can do. And then the bigger ones will come along. We have got a bigger one in the net. We don't know how big yet, but let me slip this one back and we'll get the bigger one out and we'll go from there.
With the bigger one of the two going £30, I did manage to mess up the video footage, but a passerby did manage to grab some great stills for me. And it was another two tricky syndicate fish under the belt. And surely with every capture, I was one step closer to one of these monsters. I could feel it in the air. I could taste it. It was at the edge of my fingertips. And surely next week, one of them would be mine.
Yep, after them, another two fish out of the same swim. And after them two fish, I was just so confident. Everything I was doing was working. Everything was just on the money. I just couldn't put a foot wrong at this point. And obviously, I couldn't wait to get back. The next week, and when I got back, I arrived, same again, early doors, as early as you can get here, which is 5 o'clock, and I see the fish right away. They was in a swim called West One down there in near the car park, and they was just boshing all over that swim in the morning. I went back to the van, got me barra, run round to West One, and as I got there, I noticed that the fish were getting further and further down into the middle of the lake, and I had a decision to make. And I mean, it is these decisions that lead to things happening. I don't know what it was. I just see them going towards the thing, and I thought I'll intercept them in the middle of the lake. So the only other swim that was free in the middle of the lake was a swim that controls the main body of the water, I would say, directly centre, which was handy because that's where the fish were heading. I then grabbed my barra, run round to that swim, and I thought, I've got to get these solid bags out before the fish move in. So I quickly, anything, nothing else come off the barra, my limes come off the barra, and I went about throwing three solid bags out. No, I threw two solid bags out, sorry. And the next one I put in the margin, but the red of rushes come right out of here. You can't really get the angle. So I've got another net pole in my bag, waded out. I stabbed the net pole into the ground just to create that angle so I could put a line down the margin, and I wouldn't have no worries about line lay going down to the spot, you see. The rest of the day just floated on by. I mean, I've got a couple of updates. I mean, we'll jump to them there.
The day was drifting by and not much was happening. These are the decisions that are the fine lines in fishing. Do I move? Don't I move? What do I do?
Yeah, just a quick update, everybody. Not a lot's happened, to be fair. They've been like grouping up down the margin, and the bailiff was over earlier and it said this is where they usually start spawning, but they didn't start spawning. And I'm sure they were just bathing, to be honest. But not a lot to report. I'm literally first time on here that I've gonna be able to move if I start seeing fish, because there's first time on here there's only six people on, and that's the least busiest been since I've joined. So I'm just waiting for the fish to start making their move, to be honest. I'm not sitting on me rolls. I've got two rods out in a minute, and I'm not worried about the third one at the minute. I just want to see what they're going to start doing, and if they start showing somewhere, I will adjust accordingly. Even if that's 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, it's got to be an all-nighter, I think, because I've got to give myself an opportunity to get on these fish, and with all these swims free, I've got to make the most of it. So yeah, that's about it. Day six. Session four, day six. And we got to a great start, but this the fish ain't showing like they want to be feeding, so everybody's got to be zigs. As you can see from that footage there, I was really, really stuck of what to do with my left rod. I kept it out of the water, and I was just thinking, it was really hot, I had nothing on the bottom, the fish had passed over me really, and I was actually thinking about a move. I was still playing around with my camera, because it was a new toy, and I was still playing around with that, but I really, really was stuck doing this left rod. I was actually stuck of what actually to do, full stop. Shall I move, shall I not? And then I just see one really faintly just come out of the water. Looked like a nice fish actually, and I thought I'll just do an adjustable zig, you know, and cast it to that showing fisher as a last chance. I still weren't set on staying in this swim, and that's what I did. I got an adjustable zig ready and blasted it out as far as I could to my left where I see this fish show, and then I sat back and I thought camera has got a tracking system, so it can track you about and follow you. It makes it really easier for me to get shots and stuff on my own, because it is hard on doing all the filming on your own. And I was actually up the bank at the time of I was just doing messing around with this active track. I was walking around and I just heard what sounded like peeling line off of a clutch, like zzzz. And I know that sound, and obviously I'm thinking, look, and I'm looking down at me at me rods, and that left-hand bobbins pulled right up to the tire, top to the top of the spool, ready to ping off, and I'm really, really staring at it, and all of a sudden it's pinged off. The bobbin is pinged off. So I've gone running down, couldn't believe what was actually happening. I've gone running down to the bank, looking at it, still in disbelief really, because it'd been really, really slow, and I've just picked up the rod and I've leant into it and greeted by a tug back, which means fish on. After a couple minutes scrap, I mean, it was a really, really finicky fight, and really, really, it was weird. It didn't feel like a nice fish at the time until I got a little bit closer, and then that's when it erupted. And it, you could probably hear on this video actually, it just starts tearing line. As it starts tearing line, it makes a beeline to the left-hand rushes, and I can see it happening before me. And I'm thinking, no, 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 please don't, please don't. But it's too late, it's gone into the rushes. And I'm thinking what to do, I'm locked up solid. As I've got it closer, it's come through the rushes a little bit, but then it's gone solid, and it's literally just out of net distance from me to the fish, because I can see like the little wings coming up where the tail's slapping in the rushes. I couldn't quite make it out, but I could sort of tell it was a sort of nice fish by the rings and just the tip of the tail coming out and that. And I really had a decision to make there and then. I mean, I was gonna lose this fish. It's on a zig in a way. They're little hooks. I mean, I fish my zigs with quite big hooks. I mean, at 8. But they are little hooks, and my heart is pounding. I've got a decision to make, and the decision was I had to get the waders on and go out to this fish, because the adjustable was stuck in the rushes. It was like a washing line effect, and the fish was just in there, and there was no way of getting to this fish. So I put the waders on, I jumped down there, I grabbed my net because I can make out the swells, and I thought if I can get my net just under the swells, I can get it. So I've hand lined this. Oh, all this is going on, I don't even know what fish it is at this point. I'm handlining down to the fish, as you can see in the video. And I've got this net, and I think if I can just get it under the rings and just sort of pull up on it, and that's what I did. I got it under the rings. I didn't know what I was putting into. I pulled up the net, and I've just hoped. It was just wishful hopeful thinking that I had a fish in the net, and when I pulled the net back and looked into the net, I don't really know how to describe the feeling. I don't really, well, there weren't a feeling, it was just pure amazement. Have a look at what was in the net. Right, everyone, we're losing the light, so I really wanted to get this done quick, but I should have sacked it up really and got all my stuff together, because we're 6 days in, we're a full session for the quest for the 50. I'm not sure what fish this is, but I'm not sure what you see on camera. The tripod fell over halfway through. I was mental. Once I see the fish, it just went mental. But yeah, sixth day on the quest for the 50. 52 pound, 3 ounces of Essex Miracarp. 53 pound, baby. 52.3, sorry. Quest for a 50 complete. 52.3. I'm gobsmacked. I don't know what we're sort of going to get on camera and what we ain't. I mean, I don't know what I'm coming across like, because I've not had much time to take it in. Just one run. Let's get the other side of him. It's a beast. Did I think I'd complete this early? No, I've been on pest control really. Adjustable jig, tooth on the surface. We'll go through our timer adjustables just to catch this beast. Best, a new personal best for me in anywhere in Europe. It's my biggest fish, no matter where I fished. It's my biggest fish. Oh. Come on. Yeah. Just one run. Well, I need to get some stills of her, because we're losing light and I want the best quality. Best photo quality possible. Just one run. Come on. You know, and it was a special, special, special moment in my fishing. I mean, sometimes you set yourself these challenges, not knowing how long they're going to take. And little did I know, on my seventh or sixth night, I can't really remember what it was now, that I would have the that I'd have this fish and the 50 and the quest would be complete. I mean, the emotions, the, when I mean, it sounds mad, but I took all self takes with it. I just wanted it to be me and the fish. I know it sounds a bit crazy, you just had a fish of a lifetime, you maybe want to get proper shots and stuff. I mean, I've got some really good shots and I've got it, the whole thing on video, so I'm never ever gonna forget it. Yeah, the quest for a 50 was wrapped up, and just putting that fish back and the emotion, I can't, if you could bottle it and sell it, you'd be a multi-millionaire, because it was one of the best feelings of my life. It was euphoric, and that's what we do this sport for. You can't replicate that feeling. No matter what I've done throughout my life, you cannot replicate that feeling for me. And quest for a 50 completed. Who would have thought it? So I put that fish back and then I don't really know what to do with myself. Where do I go from here? I've just set out to catch the 50. I've caught the 50, and when I thought I'd have a whole year for my channel, to film that stuff and chase it, maybe even a couple of years. But no, it was wrapped up. And where the channel goes from here, and like you say, would join me here. The lake's been closed for a month. This lake has been closed for a month. I've been doing something else, which you will see shortly. Another video coming out shortly after this one. That's where I've been for a month, chasing something else. But like I say, the show goes on, you know. The show goes on, and I'm here again. There's 40s that I've not even caught yet. I've not even had a 40. There's one that goes bigger than that, believe it or not, in here. And you know, I'm still chasing them. And that brings me round to the title of this YouTube channel, Just One Run. All I ask when I come fishing, or not ask, all I can create for myself on these difficult little pits and these tricky little waters, is if you're here for 2 days, all I ask for, I'm not a greedy person, all I ask for is that one opportunity, that one take, just to try and convert that into a fish. If you blow it, you blow it. But all I want is that one chance. Just give me that one chance, that one fish, that one moment, that one special, that one opportunity. Just one run. Quest for a 50. Complete. Come on.
I would like to thank everyone who took the time out to watch this. It really means a lot to me. If you could just do something for me, I'd be forever grateful. Just take 3 seconds out of your time there and press that subscribe button. Please, please subscribe and help me grow this channel. If tricky pits and monster carp are your thing, there's plenty more where that came from.